Training on the show today. Updates on Davido and lover Chioma. Parizo tells his own story about the breach of contract scandal. Naira Marley warns fans. Malians. Burna Boy makes Michelle Obama's top 100 workout playlist. There's a model hitter right now on the show, such a trend. So meet your host, Sydney Shocker.
And we back once again to do one thing and one thing only, and that's check out the happenings on our social media space. Are you ready? I'm ready, guys. Welcome on board. Welcome to Social Trend. My name is Sydney Shocker. Let's hit the ground running. Now, there are some happenings, some developments you think are so unthinkable. But before you say what's up, it happens. That's exactly what happened at the Adeleke family's house over the weekend. That's right, my man. Chioma and Davido are following each other, even though they refer themselves after an hour or two. Did you ever see that coming? Let's go find out what actually transpired. What led to that unfollow on Instagram?
So I am looking for the sister. Chioma, my lover. She got the dollar. She the wear designer. So I am looking for the sister. Chioma, my lover.
On Saturday, the 19th of January 2020, the unthinkable happened between lovebirds Davido and Chioma. We saw them unfollowing themselves on social media, Instagram to be specific, for about an hour before later started refollowing themselves all over again. This caused a stir, as most Nigerians fans couldn't believe what was happening or what they were seeing, and ever since then have been seeking answers to what actually transpired and triggered such resolution. We can all recall a certain King Patrick of Golden Boy Entertainment opening cans of worms, and one of such revelations was Chioma is Peruzzi's side chick, introduced to Davido, his boss, as his cousin. Or let's put it the way they did. Parizo was pimping Chioma for his boss, Davido, as his cousin.
American girls, them ballin', but they know about pass. Them buy Jimmy too, but you they buy them double. I know say London cold, so me I won't come out. I don't want to do this, I just want cut. Ajay, 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 Manati, 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 sir. Ajay, 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 Manati, Manati, Manati. Baby, would you believe if I tell you say you're the one for me, no one can take your place? Baby, would you believe if I tell you say you're the one for me, no one can?
This resulted to lots of hues and cries on social media among fans, asking if Davido was the true biological father of the son, if fine. A narrative Davido, who isn't new to such controversies, have reacted to in many ways than one. So, was this move a mere move to distract the public from the ongoing Peruzzi Davido Golden Boy Entertainment breach of contract saga? Or, like people close to the Adeleke's claim, having to do with a fourth baby mama in the works? One fact for sure is social media is always awake and watching 24/7. Let's quickly quote a fan at CuteWater who said, "So Davido and Chioma unfollowed each other on Instagram? See eh? If Davido and Chioma can break up, then it is over for love. Don't give up yet, baby girl. Love can still be real at the end of the day."
Oh my God, a whole lot going down with that family, man. For real, stories virtually everywhere. We don't know what to believe. We don't know who to follow. We don't just know what to do. But what we know is that we got our AFs to the ground for real. And that's what it is. All right. Now, still on the Davido Chioma issue, brings to mind Peruzzi. If you remember, Peruzzi trended all week long, man, having to do with breach of contract. Now, this time around, homeboy is out explaining to us his own side of the story. Let's go find out.
Cause you know they do me nothing, but baby I'm twisted. I'm twisted, I swear.
Following the explosive Twitter thread of last week by CEO Golden Boy Entertainment King Patrick over Peruzzi breaching the contract they both had in the days of yore, Peruzzi has decided to tell his own side of the story by releasing a song titled Gunshot. This was after clapping back at King Patrick's tweet, where he debunked all allegations leveled on him by Golden Boy Entertainment. He even went ahead accusing the record buzz, King Patrick, of selling songs he recorded for the label to Nollywood and pocketing all profits to himself and even more. Though he hasn't opened up on the paternity issue of Davido's child, Ifeanyi, it seems as though there are more cans of worms yet unopened. A week ago, Golden Boy Entertainment and CEO King Patrick revealed some very inflammatory information about Peruzzi and the entire DMW crew he dubbed Surviving Peruzzi. A thread where he revealed how Davido has been singing songs initially and officially recorded for Golden Boy Entertainment without no royalties or profits given to him. One of such songs was Fire.
Shorty want $1 million, so make a wire. Turn me to undercover, my girl. Aye. She say all her friends are living la vida loca. I dey fuck you, me my lover. Aye. You for there for me, you for there. When the boy they hunger, try, I for try for you. Another man picking from my wrist. Try, I love you, know me. Say if you say make a pull one hand for five.
As well as accusing Peruzzi of pimping his side chick to Davido, Choma, who is actually warm enough to become Davido's wife soonest. From the look of things, it seems we have not heard the last of it all, as more seem to be unfolding every now and then we go to bed. Social media is watching.
Mr. Peruzzi, my brother, I feel you, man. It's not easy. Like I said, stories are flying virtually everywhere. Unconfirmed speculations and stories. At the end of the day, we just pick up what we need to pick up and share with you. That's what we do. It's such a trend right here on ITV with your boy sitting in the shocker, shaking things up a little bit, you know what I mean? Switching things up like we do. Now check it out. Are you a Malian? Are you down with Naira Marley? Well, if you are, then Naira Marley's got a warning for you. Let's go find out what the woman is all about.
Man, why are you weak? Okay, listen. Why are you weak? Thousand, zero bet, 100 million buster.
The term Malians seems to have been misconstrued by millions of Naira Marley fans, known as Malians anyway, to the extent the artist and leader of the Malian nation, Naira Marley, had to come out and put the record straight, warning all Malians to desist from the very negative act of being a Malian. Before we check out what he said, let's quickly go through what Malians mean to so many people who claim to be Malians. 1. They believe Malians don't graduate. Malians don't own school certificates. Malians don't wear belts. That's for the guys. Malians never adhere to the norms of the society. While for the girls, Malians claim never to wear panties on some certain days. And to make matters worse, some actually turn the phrase into a cult, sort of. And this is amongst very young post-primary school students around the country, which is so disheartening. Hence, Naira Marley is screaming out from the studio right now, setting the record straight on what a Malian is supposed to be, look like, and do. To this, the leader of the Malian nation, Naira Marley, has proclaimed, put out a very stern warning on Twitter, where he cautioned all Malians, maintaining they shouldn't jeopardize their future in the name of being a Malian. According to Naira Marley, as a Malian, you have to enjoy your youth, but don't destroy your future. Malians don't need to be that crazy to prove any point. He went ahead shocking them all by revealing to them he is a graduate and a master's degree holder from a very prestigious university in the United Kingdom. I guess most Malians didn't see this coming. The term and phrase Malians, as adopted by his fans nationwide, has been bringing lots of negative vibes and controversies that has led to parents, men of God, and civilian outfits calling for caution. Will this stern warning from Naira Marley himself finally nip all these atrocities in the bud? I think time will tell.
Okay, dokie, Mr. Naira Marley, did you ever know he was a graduate in far away the US? sorry, the UK. Well, he is. So you're going about with the whole I'm a Malian thinking, you better work on yourself, my brother, my sister. That's what it is. Now let's go check out trends that have been happening all week long right here in Nigeria, even outside the shores of the country. I'll be back.
Remember the name, Vico. He once trended way back in the day, before the likes of Instagram and Twitter anyway. He actually claims to be the best rapper way back in the day, like the best rapper alive. Now check this out. Homeboy seemed to have beaten more than he can chew. As he alleges, he was beaten up and beaten to pops by Zango Kruna, Jelanta Nibile, and his goons on the streets of Lagos a week ago.
Yes, as I was saying, Zlatan set me up this night. With 8 of his guys, they beat me up. They dealt with me. Everybody should know that anything that happens tomorrow, nobody should blame me. Zlatan set me up. They beat me up. Him and his guys, about 8 or 9 of them. They beat me up here in Lekki. And now I'm moving back to my place. Everybody should know that anything that happened tomorrow, nobody should blame me. Zlatan set me up. Look at my eyes. They beat me up with 8 of his guys or more, if not mistakenly. Look at my face. So anything I do tomorrow, nobody should blame me. Zlatan sets me up. Everybody can see my face now.
Now, this was right after ranting about Zlatan snubbing him while he requested for his phone number days ago. Boy, what a development. But even at that, is anything wrong requesting for a phone number? Or there's more to this than we are hearing? Trust social media. Whatever is hidden will pop soon. Let's go over to the United States and check out this trend having to do with the very hot romance between American pop diva Rihanna and Saudi Arabia billionaire Hassan Jameel, coming to an end after two lovebirds called it quits right after 3 years of courting. According to close sources, they claim Jameel had been going through severe pressure from his family to dump Rihanna due to Rihanna's lifestyle and pop diva status. And trust Rihanna, never to give up her lifestyle for nobody, especially with the fact that she has to maintain her brand and her persona, pushing her record sales, as well as her newly floated clothing line and cologne, Fenty. Is that bad that the Saudi billionaire has paid off bloggers and journalists requesting to stop using pictures of both of them together while illustrating the reports on their news platforms? Whew! Can somebody give this guy my phone number, man? I need to be paid as well, yeah? Anyway, they were last spotted together in 2019 at the Amalfi Coast Love Nest, cuddling, smiling, laughing during a lunch date. And from there, they moved to Los Clogi in Italy to continue the good times. While in August, they were both seen with Rihanna's mother, Monica, and Rihanna's brother at Mason in Santa Monica in Europe. Though they have always tried their possible best to keep their relationship extremely private, why wonder why they couldn't hold it together any longer? As the ongoing breach of contract beef between Peruzzi, Davido, and King Patrick of Golden Boy Entertainment lingers on, Patrick has opened up more cans of worms, as this time around, he's accusing Davido of stylishly plotting to poison him while they were partying as a result of the ongoing breach of contract scandal that has been lingering for a very long time.
As I speak to you now, I have Davido songs on my phone that he has not released that are owned by Golden Boy Entertainment. I have Peruzzi songs for Davido that he has not released. That owned by Golden Boy Entertainment. Mm. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
One of his schools, nothing. As far as not being jammed, Amaka, Amaka. So everything since Fire, After Fire, the only song that is not written by Peruzzi is the worst song he released since After Fire, which is what? Guess what? Flora My Flower. That's the worst song that he released, actually. Mm. And guess who wrote that song? He wrote that song. That's why you are untalented it is. I don't even care if you're recording this phone call. I don't care. Tell them I said, pay me. Pay my money or I'll come for you. And I don't even expect them to pay me. If they don't pay me, I will still collect it. Now Davido is begging. He came to Abuja to come and beg now. I told him, Baba, I don't listen to broke people like you. They beg you on this. They are begging me on the side. As I'm talking to you now, they are begging. And now I still start with people now. Calm down. I don't want to go into this. Davido went personal with me. This put drugs my drink. Uh-uh. On my birthday, the same way they drugged my drink and Tago's drink to kill him.
Mm.
I was now acting up because my body's strong. My body's strong. Drug knows to kill me.
Mm.
You know, they're calling me saying I'm a crackhead. But I want to go there. That palu way they smoke. He thinks I don't know what you pay inside. That ego way they smoke. You know, pass the drug way you give me. Have you just to Fire by Davido? This is the lyrics closely.
Yes, I have.
Peruzzi wrote that song for Chioma to throw Davido inside life, man. Peruzzi wrote Fire by brought fire to throw Davido. Mm. Go and listen to the lyrics. Let another man run my race. When Davido, when the boy, the hunter, bro, nobody is stupid, though. We're not stupid. I've been keeping quiet. Mm. When we all go there, Baba, here, if I start going there, excess luggage, I will go with you. Excess luggage. Now, why who put up? Did he reply? He didn't reply now. She ain't no reply. You ought to go mouth to mouth. That's not my evidence.
Inside life, you say? Now, check this out. For we that work in the media houses, we never want any distraction to come our way, especially in the line of duty. That's exactly what happened right here. Between this channel's TV reporter and a certain distractor, so to speak, that was approaching his way while on the line of duty.
You heard the commissioner of police say live on television that there will be investigations.
Nothing stops the show because the show must go on. Nigerian prolific singer Asha, in a monitored interview, revealed she was scammed millions of naira in 2019 by unknown scammers while in Nigeria. The singer, who confessed being a Malian, said, "It is so sad how fraudsters dupe people of their hard-earned money." According to her, one needs to be very alert and prayerful while dealing with Nigerians, even as a Nigerian.
Perhaps I'll be as popular as my Naira Mali.
Hey! Are you a Malian?
I think I am. I love him. I think he's awesome.
Yeah.
How amazing he is. You see, he's gone on.
Yes, yeah. Yes.
It got me thinking of what was your stand on Yahoo Yahoo, but we won't go into that.
No, it's okay.
So you're saying the Malian philosophy, we take a bit, but we don't take all of it.
They touched my bank account, you know, they emptied it.
They did?
Yes, let's not go there.
Oh,
no, okay. Let's just stick to the song.
The artist, who is signed to a French musical label and based in France, commended Naira Mali for his dogged attitude towards life and his musical career, thereby proclaiming she is a Malian. Well known for her sultry alternate soul music, Asha broke into the limelight in 2012 with mind-blowing singles such as Fire on the Mountain and Ara. And finally, can you imagine what these girls are doing to world-class Big Brother Niger anchor, Ebuka?
Ebuka, on the Suya Park. This is serious. Come and join us.
Let me see his shoes.
No. Give him garbage. He likes garbage.
They cut his leg up. I know you slept for me.
Aww.
You made it to my Suya Park. A high five.
Anyway, it's good to know that is how close they can ever get across to him. Trends.
Okie dokie, my man. Yeah, trends will never stop hitting us back to back on social media. I mean, they are the integral part of social media, man. They must be there. Trends must break at all times. Now, Oluwa Bonner Boy, just made Michelle Obama's top 100 playlists. Her workout playlist, actually, yeah. And number four, I'm talking about a song, My Money, My Baby. Can you beat that? Let's go find out how it goes there on number four on Michelle Obama top 100 playlist song for the year 2020. As he awaits the Grammys come February, this very energetic self-proclaimed African giant, Burner Boy, isn't relenting as he continuously break international and national records on the daily. One of his songs, My Money, My Baby, a brilliant rehash of Fela 70s hit song, debuted on Michelle Obama's top 100 workout playlist to everyone's amazement. According to the former US First Lady, she decided to share the top 100 workout playlist with the world in order to encourage those who must have adopted body fitness as a resolution this year, 2020.
Mama dem ko do me, papa dem ko do me, sister dem ko do me, brother dem ko do me. Then don't ya one story, then don't see one story. Read them for newspaper, see them for television. Then get up for radio, then talk up for radio. Then talk who say I don't kill the person.
Though Bonner frowns at Nigerian awards, claiming they can be easily bought, hence is more at home with international awards, there are very strong beliefs in certain quarters that the Grammys will be won by him in February as he warms up to knock hands with the likes of Angelique Kidjo and other heavyweight artists from around the world. So as we await February and the Grammys, let's wish the brother well. Burner.
Man, when is your time? Is your time. Nobody can hold you down for real. Believe that, man. Believe that. Top 5 trending videos is up next. Desire, are you ready? Roll them out.
Top 5 trending videos of the week. Top 5 trending videos of the week.
Rita, what did you just ask me?
You don't know Grandpa?
Yeah, I know Grandpa. Why?
Because in the night you will keep yelling at Mama and who is your daddy? Who is your daddy?
Rita, what did you just ask me?
You don't know Grandpa?
Yeah, I know Grandpa. Why?
Because in the night you will keep yelling at Mama and who is your daddy? Who is your daddy?
Top 5 trending videos of the week. Top 5 trending videos of the week.
Manchester United.
Oh. And who's your favourite player?
None of them. They're all rubbish. Oh. Manchester United. Oh.
And who's your favourite player?
None of them. They're all rubbish. Oh.
Top 5 trending videos of the week. Top 5 trending videos of the week.
And how can I leave here without sharing with you what we call our goof of the week? You want to laugh? Here we go.
Goof of the week.
Yay! I get down. Yes. My look at that. This guy go fall down. Just help us and fight. Make it get the shot, I beg. I'll grab him out of there. Hey!
Goof of the week.
So that's how we wrap things up today on the show. I must thank you so much for watching. Don't forget, Social Trend hits you every Thursday on our satellite broadcast, GoTV 107, start times 1:30, yeah, and the repeat broadcast every Sunday at 1:30, man, on Channel 22. And Thursdays, it's 4:30 p.m. on our satellite broadcast. My name is Sydney Shaka. I love you. One thing I know for sure is I'll be back here, same time, next week, as far as you've got your data and social media burning. Ciao.